Hello guys, and welcome back to my channel. In this video, I'm going to be talking about what are the most important things that you have to make sure whenever you are buying a bike with an IMU. So how does an IMU work? That's what I'm going to explain you in this video. So IMU stands for Inertial Measurement Unit, and I'm going to be explaining you how it works and what are the parameters and all the sensors that has been using. Basic electronic aid that has been, so it's not basic, but it's becoming a basic need in terms of every later class motorcycle. So let's get started with the video. So what the first thing that you need to consider in an IMU is, how does it work? In an IMU, the basic function is to calculate the acceleration and also the orientation of a bike. So how does it does is with the help of a lot of sensors like the accelerometer, the gyrometer, the magnetometer, and all the different types of sensors that has been put into an IMU. So in an IMU, the major improvement was from the 5-axis IMU to the 6-axis IMU. So the last generation, I mean the from 2017, whatever the Fireblade has been released, was an 5-axis IMU it was equipped with, but all the latest generation Fireblade from the 2020, but in the Panigales as well from the V4, it has been using an 6-axis IMU. So I'm going to be explaining you about 6-axis IMU in this video. So in a 6-axis IMU, it is again divided into two parts, which is the translational and the rotational components. So in the rotational components, there are three terms again, which is the pitch, roll, and yaw. So in pitch, it basically calculates the amount of diving that the bike is going through whenever you are braking, and also squat whenever you are accelerating the bike. In rolling, it calculates the amount of that the bike is going through, whatever the parameter that is it calculating whenever you are entering a corner or whenever you're going through a corner. So, and a yaw is the change of direction of a bike, whether you are moving from left to right or right to left. In a translational component, again, there are three component categories that it has been divided into. So the first is the longitudinal. It calculates the movement of the bike from front to back. The second category is the lateral movement, which basically calculates the bike's movement from side to side, and the third category is the vertical, which calculates the movement of the bike from up and down in terms of vertical movement. So this helps in the tracks or the roads which are very uneven and have lots of uphills and downhills. So all this calculation in detail is done by the IMU by calculating the acceleration through rate of change of time. It also helps in deceleration as well, not only in the acceleration part. So IMU is just a part of calculation, but it is not the main brain that is giving all the information to all the hardware, whether it's a suspension which will be a semi-active, or a braking system, or a acceleration to the rear wheel. So all the calculation that has been done in the IMU is sent into the ECU, which again distributes all the basic needs whichever is going through or whichever the rider is expecting to operate through all the hardware. So IMU will calculate all the basic information that has been gaining in it and sends to the ECU, which helps to send it to the bike's hardware. So it's gonna calculate the acceleration or the deceleration, braking, and all the terms, and it's also gonna calculate your acceleration and braking input even if you are entering a corner or rolling through a corner, or even if you are exiting a corner. It all helps in terms of the performance of your bike to go as fast as possible. And IMU is also equipped with components like the cornering ABS, the lean sensitive angle measurement, and also one more thing which is very becoming common in nowadays is the slide control. I'm gonna explain you all these parameters in few minutes. So the first parameter is the traction control, and there is one more advanced name for it, which is also known as the lean angle sensitive traction control. So basically what traction control is, it calculates the amount of speed that front and back wheel is rotating at, and if there is any uneven speed either of the wheel is rotating, it's gonna equal it such that the bike will not get out of control of the rider. But in lean angle sensitive traction control system, it's not like that, because in lean angle sensitive traction control system, it basically will be helping you if you are going through a corner, and it will sense the lean angle of the bike, and it's gonna give the right amount of brake pressure if you are braking into a corner or through a corner, or it will send the right amount of power to the rear wheel if you are trying to accelerate while entering or exiting a corner, so such that you are move your bike as fast as possible in a safe manner. So there is another function for a sensitive lean angle or traction control, which basically will send more power and torque to the rear wheel if your bike is upright. That's a very good thing whichever the bike is equipped with, because your bike can have lots of traction in a straight line more than whenever your bike is moving in a corner, because a lot of the weight is put on the tire and on the wheels, so that it can handle lots of torque as well, such that you can go through or accelerate in a crazy manner, such that you can also take over your every opponent or even your friends if you're trying to race with them. The second basic thing which IMU takes care of is the ABS. So the basic ABS function is to take out all the fear inside you from skidding of the bike. So it's gonna apply the pressure in a periodic manner such that it will not make the any wheel to lock up and bring the bike to a halt in a safe manner. So there is one more advanced ABS system in this IMU, which is known as the cornering ABS system. So basically what it does is, whenever you are entering into a corner or rolling through a corner or even exiting through a corner, it will send the right amount of braking and the right amount of acceleration such that you are not at all gonna lose traction at your rear wheel. So there are a lot of chances of skidding your bike in a corner than in a straight line, because there is only little amount of contact patch between the ground and the wheel in a corner then in your whenever you are moving in a straight line. So it's gonna basically help the wheels to have lots of traction and bring back the bike from any speed you are going to halt if you're trying to stop the bike, or even if you're accelerating, it will give it in a such a manner that it will not at all gonna make your bike misbalanced or fall in case of acceleration. And all this is gonna function inside the IMU and send it to the ECU. So in the IMU, it's gonna calculate the lean angle, it's gonna calculate the amount of acceleration or the amount of throttle you are giving to the bike. That's how all these sensors help to the IMU to calculate all these parameters. There is one more function that I told you, that is the slide control. So slide control is all about the amount of slide that you can give it to the bike whenever you are going through a corner. So how a slide control work is, it's gonna calculate your lean angle, it's gonna calculate your braking pressure and also your accelerator. So if you are giving a throttle to a bike and if your slide control is on, the slide is gonna be such that it's gonna hold its line throughout the corner and help you to exit the corner while sliding the rear end. So it's gonna basically, it's like a off-roading thing, because these it's gonna switch off the rear wheel ABS and it's gonna keep the ABS only to the front wheel and helps you with basically getting a nice photograph or a video if you are performing at the track. Even in the road it is very helpful, but I don't think in India there are a lot many roads that's gonna help this slight control. IMU is an pretty good electronic aid that is becoming more and more common. So I guess it is helpful for a rider whoever wants their bike to be a lot more than a bike. So that's all with this video, guys. Make sure you subscribe to my channel if you enjoyed the video, and like my information, and see you in the next video. Peace.